What kind of adjustments did you make for the second half?
I mean, we just, you know, first and second down there in the first half was killing us. We couldn't, you know, we were finding ourselves in a lot of second and long, second and 15s. And against that front with those pass rushers, that's a hard down and distance. So we just talked about everybody just relax and just get ahead of the change, stay on target. And, you know, I think you saw it kind of come to life there in the fourth quarter.
Well, was there a point during that fourth quarter where you felt like we got this, we can get this thing and get a touchdown?
I mean, after the second, after Funch's touchdown, and then we got the two-point conversion to go down three with four something left, I felt like if we got the ball back, we kind of had it going there offensively. We thought in that no-huddle tempo, we kind of had them on their heels. We thought if we got the ball back, we'd have a chance. And then, obviously, fourth and 10 was not a great situation, but that was Cam and Torrey just making a great play and kept our hopes alive.
You were able to cap that drive off with the touchdown, a great play call with some of the run action in there and setting you free to get that grab.
Yeah, that was all play call. That's as easy as it. I didn't really have to do too much. There was a great scheme. We talked all week. That was going to be our first, you know, goal to go, you know, down there in the goal line area. And when Cam got stopped on the, you know, real short there in the play before, everyone kind of knew what was coming and everybody sold it real well. And you know, that was pretty easy.
Greg, what changed the last three drives?
I think we're really good when we don't huddle. I think it just took getting ahead, staying ahead of the chains. You know, even if you just get a couple yards and be second eight, second seven, second six. In the first half, we'd be doing all right, and then we'd have a tackle for loss or a penalty or a sack or something. And against that front, it's going to be hard to just drop back all day and throw the ball. You know, they're getting pretty close. That's as good as it gets. Our guys up front fought their ass off. I think when we got into that tempo and just stayed on rhythm and stayed ahead of the chains, it allowed us to just kind of settle in a little bit. And then you saw guys, all different guys, making plays. Curtis, DJ on the big third down there. Curtis's touchdown. Funch had another good game. You know, big games, big catches. Torrey, I don't know if he caught another ball, but that was the biggest play of the game on fourth and 10. You know, it was scattered around to a lot of guys.